Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I really did not plan what I was going to say to you because I didn't know how I would feel, but I'm so, so grateful that you came and filled this church for us today. We appreciate it so much. Music is a shared art. It's very difficult to enjoy communicating music through a laptop or screen. So thank you so much for coming today. Nobody knows what the next few months are going to be like, but we're just taking it one month at a time, and we're very, very happy to see you here tonight. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. This composer, teacher, organist, pianist, French through and through, Gabriela Fauré, came from sort of a cultured family, but not with, the family wasn't very musical. But for some reason, this little kid had talent, So they sent him, he was born in the south of France in 1845, and he was sent away to Paris to study at the L'École Niedermeyer at the age of 9 years old. And he stayed there getting a broad, broad education in all things music. And actually the school was trained its musicians to be an organist and a choir master. So that's what he was really trained to do as a teenager. And he graduated at the age of 19 in 1865. And when he was a student, he met Camille Saint-Saëns. And Saint-Saëns sort of took him under his wing, and they were lifelong friends after that. So he graduated, and he started a very modest life of playing the organ and teaching. That's what he did for a living. And he spent so much time doing that that he had very little time to compose. But compose he did, and the kind of pieces that he composed were small, short songs, short pieces, and chamber music. Nothing big, nothing symphonic. The only pieces that he wrote that were for a symphony was the Fauré Requiem with choir and a couple other pieces. But he really, that wasn't his thing. And he lived in Paris and got gigs. Actually, Saint-Saëns helped him find jobs, always complaining that he didn't have enough time to compose. In the last 20 years of his life, he played the organ in Madeleine, a big church in Paris. He had got great jobs. He became the director of the Paris Conservatory. And he wrote some of his best, I don't know how to say, sort of charmingly reticent, sort of inner searching type of music in the last 20 years of his life, which would have been the first decade of the 20th century. He died in 1924. This trio is one of the last pieces he ever wrote. He wrote it in 8 months. His publisher suggested that he write a piano trio because he never had. But he wrote this piece, and it was performed right after it was finished in the spring of 1923. He passed away maybe a year and a half later in 1924, but he was lucky enough to hear it performed a couple times, especially by the famous Courtauld, Thibault, and Casals trio that took it up almost right away and sort of championed it and brought it to. So it's funny, in this concert, we are playing two works from composers very early in their lives, but this one is composed at the very end of his life. And the other thing I wanted to say is he also taught Nadia Boulanger. I don't know if you know who she was, very famous. She taught the likes of Aaron Copland, a huge amount of composers, and I just had a birthday, a few days ago, and I forgot that she was the first woman to conduct full programs in Boston Symphony, New York Phil, and I think Philadelphia as well, and also in London, some orchestras. First woman to be able to conduct full concerts. She loved Fauré. Fauré was her teacher, and when he died, she was very, very upset. Anyway. Thank you.
One of Mendelssohn's greatest and earliest masterpieces was the octet he wrote for strings when he was just a teenager. He wrote it for a birthday present for his friend Edward Rietz, who was turning 23. He was a good family friend. And the quintet we're about to play was composed just the following year when Mendelssohn was only 17 years old. This is yet another quintet that was not written for the flute, just like the Dvorak and the Mozart quintets that we played last year. They are viola quintets, meaning there are two violas, two violins, this is supposed to be a violin, and a cello. It is believed that the piece was written with his friend Rietz in mind for the first violin part. And in any case, this is a very youthful and exuberant work of a 17-year-old composer that I really think you will enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.